I have 3 tips for people moving over to Mastodon. So a lot of the Apple community of content creators, writers, developers, podcasters, and peasants, and ordinary fans have all moved over from Twitter to Mastodon. I've been using it for a few months now, so I have some tips for all the newcomers. Tip number 1, don't worry so much about which instance you pick. There's no singular Mastodon that you sign up for. Just like email, you have to pick a specific server. Now you can still follow anybody from anywhere. There's no real limitations there. Most of the servers are completely free, but if you want to get on mastodon.social, which is the biggest one, you can use Cultimax invitation link if you click there or in the video description. There is actually one hitch that you need to think about. So if you have somebody's profile open in Safari and you want to follow them, you can only press the follow button if you're on the same instance. Otherwise, you need to open their profile as it appears on your own instance. It sounds complicated and annoying, because it is, but that brings me to tip number 2. I have a few ways you can work around this. So I'm looking at this account in Safari, and it's hosted on mastodon.social. Now I can't just tap the follow button, it won't do anything, because mastodon.social isn't the server that manages my account. But I have a few third-party apps on my phone that make that really easy. You tap the share button, scroll down a little bit, and I have these 3 actions right here, because I have these 3 third-party apps on my phone. So I can just tap open in Mona. Oh, and there it is. I can see that I'm already following them. It's really that simple. Now you might not want to be thrown out to another app, and you might want to stay inside Safari. Well, the king of shortcuts himself, Federico Vitici, has a solution for you. You tap the share button, and I have this Siri shortcut called Masto-Redirect. You tap it, and in a new tab, it opens up the same profile on the same account, and I can see that I'm already following them. Both of these are so convenient and effective that the whole follow people from your own instance problem might as well not exist. Tip number 3. So while Twitter is charging people money for the privilege of keeping their account secure, you can set up 2-factor authentication on Mastodon for free really easily. It's the best kind of security because it keeps your account way more secure, and it's so well integrated into the iPhone and the Mac that it's a completely invisible process. Let me show you how to set it up. Now say I have this account here and I want to add 2-factor authentication. Well, you tap the settings button, you tap this menu and you go to account, then you tap this menu again and you go to 2-factor auth and you tap setup. Now you can bring up the QR code on a computer and then scan it with your phone, but I'm doing this all on my iPhone. So I'm just gonna copy this code right here. Then you open up settings and you scroll down to passwords. Then you wanna scroll down and open up the password for your Mastodon account and you tap setup verification code. This is where you'd scan the QR code if you have 2 devices, but I'm just gonna tap enter setup key and paste what I copied earlier and tap okay. Then you'll get this verification code here. You copy that. And you can see that it's already recommending it, so you just tap this. It'll do Face ID again, and there you go. Now you'll be given these 2-factor codes. You'll want to like screenshot these or write them down somewhere or keep them somewhere else. So if you ever lose access to your device, you can still get into your account. But don't bother trying to hack this account. It'll already be deleted by the time this video is published. Wait, one more thing. You can follow Cult of Mac on Mastodon. We post all of our news, reviews, how-tos, setups, guides, all on Mastodon as soon as they're published. And you can follow me on Mastodon. For some reason. Wait, one last thing. I'm gonna go through some of my favorite apps that I've been trying out. Ice Cubes is free and open source for iPhone, iPad, and Macs with Apple Silicon. And it's a pretty good app. It has all the basic features. The official Mastodon client is available for iPhone and Android, if Android compatibility matters to you. Being the official app, it supports all the basic features, as you can expect. It looks and works pretty similarly to the website. Mona is the one I'm trying out for iPhone, iPad, and Mac, even on the Intel Macs. What I love about this one is that the timeline sync between the iPhone and the Mac is like lightning fast. I didn't even think that iCloud was capable of syncing anything that fast. It isn't officially released on the App Store yet, but you can find links to join the test flight in the video description. Ivory by Tapbots is resurrected from the bones of Tweetbot, which was one of the most popular Twitter clients. This is very well polished, very well designed, and easily the most reliable one that I've tried out so far. A Mac version is coming, but it's not available yet, and you can buy it right now in the App Store. Mammoth is another one for iPhone and Mac by Shihab Mahboob. This one is very fully featured, easily the most pro features of any of the apps I've tested so far, and it looks very much at home on the iPhone. So those are all of my Mastodon tips. You can find links to everything I talked about in the video description. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.